You know, people have looked at epidemiologic, you know, associations between lymphoma and toxic exposure to chemicals, electromagnetic radiation. There hasn't been really a tight link for Hodgkin's disease. There are some suggestions that you can certainly develop lymphomas and leukemias if you're exposed to chemicals or toxins like Agent Orange, for instance, with the Vietnam vets, and some of the Gulf War vets as well were exposed to various chemicals. But you really have to have a definitive exposure. For many of our patients who come in, you know, we do a very careful epidemiologic assessment to really to find out, you know, where they've been, where they grew up, and whatever. And we don't really find an association. Now, that's not to say that there aren't chemicals that we're all exposed to in our environment. We don't even know what they are. There was an interesting study done here by the epidemiology group at Yale, the School of Public Health, where they actually found a link between hair dye and the development of lymphoma. This was a number of years ago now. They did a huge epidemiologic study and asked a lot of questions of patients with lymphoma, and they were focusing more on sun exposure and smoking and all those kinds of things. But they, interestingly, they picked up the association with hair dye, and then they went on to show actually in the lab that it was the former kind of formulation of hair dye had specific chemicals that could lead to lymphoma. And since then, hair dyes have been changed over, so you know we're safe now. The ones that we use are probably safe. But that's a really good example of how you do an epidemiologic study, you know, and you come up with something that you wouldn't have expected a priori. So I would say with Hodgkin's, we don't have any definitive answers yet about specific links to any chemicals, toxins, or other factors, but that's not to say that there isn't something out there.